It's just going to start with, like, Isaac going, "Jeez Louise."
That's good.
Yeah, no, it was just the, like, intro of Isaac. It was pretty funny. Anyway, hi, everybody. How's everyone doing? Hopefully I actually
hi, everybody.
Updated this.
Oh, God, mute the stream. There we go.
Hello, everybody. So, Mike isn't feeling very good. So he's not around, so we're obviously not going to do Grimrock without him. So I'm just going to do some Isaac runs tonight. It might be kind of a short stream so that I can go, like, take care of him and stuff.
Mike Pussy Malbec.
Oh, he's not a pussy. I just baby sick people. That's all. He has a fever and doesn't feel good, and I feel real bad about it. But anyway, I am going to go ahead and start just playing some Isaac, just for funsies.
Sweet.
Yeah. I can ask you questions of things that I'm not sure about, which is great, because I come across that, like, all the time in my Let's Play.
I am pretty good at Isaac. I'm no Biznav.
But who I met, by the way, blew my How's mind. He? What?
How is he?
He's awesome.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's real cool.
I heard he's, like, super hot. People have been talking about it on Twitter forever.
He's an attractive man. He's no Mike Malbec, but...
Right.
Okay, I just re-rolled the shears into Speedball. I'm gonna see if I can get another re-roll before... Whatever. Yeah, Speedball isn't my favorite. It'll do. One speed up is about what I like to be at. But if I can get something better, I will definitely try to. What?
What race would you say Biznap looks like? Asks Larkin.
Half black, half white, maybe?
That's what I think, too. It just seems like a really inappropriate question.
How is everybody doing tonight?
He's the pro. Yeah, he posted so many pictures of himself, Larkin, and in many of them, he's the only male.
Mike is on my fucking account in chat right now.
Oh, nice.
This could go horribly wrong.
You know what's about to happen.
I can't ban myself.
Yeah. Black and something that speaks Spanish. Welp.
Wow.
Here we go.
I just walked right into that projectile and I feel real bad about it.
Emerson, your head is too small to be hot. Like, maybe if people could see your face without a magnifying glass, you could be attractive.
Oh, jeez, Louise. Alright, so I think I'm gonna fight... Oh, man! If only I had a key. Let's see if the secret room could get us into the library. Maybe? Aw, shit! Okay, well, I know what I'm using my next reroll on. We're taking Speedball, it looks like. Because I have a library here. So I should just prioritize rerolls on that, right?
No, because you'll just get more books.
Right. But once I get all the books out of the rotation...
That's not going to happen on floor one. Okay. It actually takes a long time to get all the books out of the rotation. Because there's like... I think there's at least like 6 or 7
four,
books.
It takes 4 rerolls to get all the books.
Well, I don't think so. I think it's at least... 5 because like you can get 2 of the same book.
Unix, thank you so much for the subscribe. Everybody get your fart slides going in chat. Every sub is a step closer to living the dream. Thank you so much for the support. It's amazing and I love you. All right, I am going to fight the boss then and see what the boss gives me, and if it's something shittier than Speedball, then we'll reroll that. That is not very likely. I'm assuming we're going to get like a health up or something.
But yeah, the fact that you can get 2 books at once, or like 2 of the same book at once, means you can reroll, I think, up to 7 times.
Oh, that's true.
But on average, it will be like 5 or 6. But still, it's real bad. It's definitely worth trying for, but only if you have rerolls that you don't want to use on anything else, because it's rare to get that many libraries.
Yeah, that's true. You can't count on getting more libraries. Mm-mm. Man, we could use some damage, taking an awful long time to kill Pin.
It's not that bad. I mean, he probably has the same health as Monstro.
I took damage on Pin. Oh, I have the speedball and the eight ball. Both are so shitty.
You didn't bomb into the book room.
I know I didn't bomb into the book room.
Also, Larkin doesn't know the word for library, which doesn't surprise me too much. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, what should I reroll?
I would reroll the eight ball.
Okay.
Because yeah, gotta help up. Just shot speed up.
And like a card, right?
And a card, yeah.
Yeah, fuck
and
that.
Speedball is a speed up and a shot speed up.
All right. We will go pick up Speedball and head on down to the next floor. Oh, Emerson, thank you for the resub. That's super nice of you. Oh, I appreciate Emerson. The support. Get those fart slides going.
I want Emerson to have Twitch subscribers just so that his little icon for Twitch subscribers can be a stick figure with a tiny head.
That would be pretty good.
I would like that.
All right. Fucking Cellar 2. I would say I didn't see that coming, but I totally did. I always get Wrath of the Lamb floors, like always.
By always, do you mean like 50% of the time?
No, like seriously so much.
You know, I had a crazy Isaac-related revelation recently. I was watching Katie stream Isaac, and I was like, fuck. She's a lot better at Isaac than I am at this point.
Like, just better at, like, dodging or, like, knowing things?
Probably both, because she watches some BizNet, but, like, I don't know. I know enough about Isaac that I'm near the cap. But just in terms of, yeah, mechanical skill, she's really good at it. And I just don't play anymore.
I'm like, definitely pretty bad at Isaac.
I play like once a week for head-to-head at this point. That's it.
That's crazy. You don't... When did you stop your Let's Play?
Oh, man. I have no idea. Probably many months ago now.
Like, that's insane. I'm
probably going on a year.
Wow. Yeah. I am shocked.
Yeah,
okay, these spiders are gonna hit me!
Like, I spent long enough feeling obligated to play The Binding of Isaac that I, like, don't ever get that urge to play it anymore. Like, I just spent so much time playing it.
I still have a real good time playing it. I just got the small rock, and that makes me happy.
Nice.
Yeah. I would never reroll that.
I enjoy my, like, one Isaac run a week, but I don't have any urge to play more afterwards. I'm just like, that was fun.
Halo flies. I kind of want to just take it. I think I'm going to go fight the boss and see what the boss has before I make a decision.
Oh, man. Speaking of bosses, do you want an exclusive reveal on the next head-to-head challenge?
Yes, I do.
In this video? All right. So Zen and I were talking about it. And we're going to... Halo Flies is so good, man. You should pick that up.
I said I wanted to take it, and then you were just, like, silent. So I was, like, expecting some reason why I shouldn't take it.
I'm sorry. I was reading the chat.
That's A-okay.
Paying attention to you.
That's 100% A-okay.
But we were talking about, like, ways to implement Mask of Infamy, because a lot of people wanted that to happen. Uh-huh. And so here's what we're going to do. We're going to, every time we walk into a boss room, we're going to pause the game, spawn a Mask of Infamy, and have to fight both at the same time.
Oh, my God. Why would you do that? Ew.
It's going to be so good.
Yeah, and I got the pills, so I'm going to reroll the pills. Like the mom's coin purse.
Yeah. That's reasonable. I don't know.
Yeah, I got meat. Like, not sad.
Yeah, meat is really good. I kind of like taking the pill case just because it's potentially four pills revealed.
Yeah.
You know, rotation, which is...
I'm more into rerolling that when I have the opportunity to, for sure. But if I have it, like, if I have no choice, like, if I can't reroll it, then I'll take it. 100 times out of 100. But my tears are already red, so I'm not sad about the
meat, yeah.
Yeah, not even a little bit.
Halo 5 is fucking great. I love that item.
It is really good. Okay, so we have a boss trap room. I don't know why I just called it that. I always call it an arena. Ooh, and I have Guppy's Tail. Ooh, I have Guppy's Tail. I think I want to take it.
Yeah. Guppy's Tail is really good. A lot of people, like, people still think of it as, like, just increasing locked chests.
It increases all chests.
But it increases normal chests as well. Which, you know, like, so the argument of, oh, it gives you less keys is, I think, kind of moot because normal chests give you a lot of keys.
Fucking might as well take this lipstick.
You gonna blow 3 hearts? To
fuck
go
yeah!
Like, with no hearts on the ground.
Yep.
This is some ballsy shit.
You should watch me play this game sometime. I live dangerously.
Oh yeah, that range up. Hashtag worth.
I totally took, I don't know. Range ups aren't terrible.
No, they aren't.
They're definitely not my favorite, but having one or two of them definitely doesn't make me sad.
I wouldn't call them good.
I never get, like, psyched to see one, but, like, they can be important for sure. Like, especially if you get something that reduces your range.
I'm gonna be honest, I was half expecting Monster to, like, one-shot you there.
Really?
Like, the giant tears that he shoots at? Like, he shoots a spray of tears, right? And the big ones do a full
heart.
Do a full heart, yeah.
I know.
So if you fucked up at all, then he would destroy you.
Nope, we're good. And I can go to the shop now. And I'm... Wait, Greed can't be in there in the cellar, can he? Shitty city.
Not in the cellar one. He can be in the...
He can be in cellar too?
Sorry, I was thinking caves. He can be in caves too and beyond.
Okay. It's too bad I don't have a reroll available. Really? Okay. I can definitely turn him up. Speak to us, Green.
Alright, how's that, chat?
Should be better. Should be lots better.
By chat, I mean Mike Pussy Malbec.
Aww. Okay. This was absolutely... This is a good floor. This was a real good floor. I really wish I had a reroll, though.
Yeah, PAX Box is when, like, you wear yourself out for days at a time and then are exposed to thousands of people and you get all these, like, little minor illnesses, and because you didn't sleep the whole time and were probably drunk the whole time, your immune system is compromised and you get sick. That's PAX Box.
I didn't get drunk at all. I had a couple drinks when I met Cobalt Streak and Morag and played Cards Against Humanity with them, but I didn't get drunk even once.
Oh man, live Cards Against Humanity would be so fun.
Yeah, it was a really good time. They didn't play quite like us, so it would have been more fun if it was like people that... Well, I don't want to say it would have been more fun. Like, it would have been...
More enjoyable.
I don't want to say that either. I don't know why I
a
came
better
to this
time.
Fucking shop. Well, I might as well buy this fucking soul heart now. I can't believe I came into that shop.
Like, fall that creator of some porn website. Yeah, Travis definitely seems like the kind who would not be sober the entire trip.
He was definitely, definitely drunk on the first night.
Yeah.
That is for sure.
It's reasonable. Man, if I went to PAX, like, the only thing stopping me from being drunk the whole time is that bars are super expensive.
Also, getting up super early is kind of a priority if you want to get anything done.
I can drink and then get up early. Like, I really don't get hangovers.
I am very jealous. Ah. My hangovers take me out of commission until, like, 5 p.m. the next day.
Oh, that sucks a lot.
Yeah, it's the worst.
Yeah, so sometimes if I drink a lot and forget to, like, chug
my
glass of water.
Sorry. Keep
you
talking.
Okay?
Yeah.
Oh. If I forget to chug my glass of water before I go to bed, then I'll, like, have a headache when I wake up, but I'm all right. Like, I also, part of it is probably that I have super chronic headaches, so I'm just used to functioning with a headache.
Yeah. That's the worst.
Yeah. It's not so bad, though.
I wish I would find a key and then this fucking item room. It'd be real good. Thomas wasn't drunk the whole time. He went to bed pretty early the second night. Well, not really. We kept him up, kinda. He kept
what
us up.
What sound does zebras make? Don't zebras just make the same sound as horses, basically?
That's exactly what I was saying when they were debating this.
He didn't believe you.
Nope. They did not take my word for it. I might die here, and that's ridiculous because I am OP.
Yeah, you have a pretty good build right now. But you did, like, blow all of your health on that range up.
Worth.
You're fine.
Gonna need a key, like, immediately. Oh, shit! There it is. I just died.
No!
I totally died.
Oh my god, I can't wait to see what happens.
I fucked myself into a corner really bad.
Oh yeah, this is the room for it to happen, yep. For sure. Oh god, that's frustrating.
I totally thought that I had it too, which was the worst part. Everybody's gonna be so mad at me right now in chat.
This update, Spooner W needs his diaper change.
Oh, stop it! He's sick, you guys. You're terrible. When I'm sick, everybody's like, "Poor Doxy."
Oh yeah, you're
Mike
a girl.
Gets sick. Everybody's like, "Fucking man like, up."
Just, yeah, exactly. Diaper, man. Shut up. You don't have to man up because you're a girl.
I will never man up. That's a lie.
Update,
I man up
DDC
all the time.
Equals one.
Nice.
That is also a good point.
I could put a Doxy death counter up, but I shouldn't. I really shouldn't die too many times, like at all. I just got the fucking Polaroid.
Man, the Skype call just started acting up a lot. But
did
I think
it?
I interested you. Yeah. Do I sound okay to you?
Yeah, you sound perfectly fine to me.
That's good. That's the important part.
Mike must be loading some. Oh, Wiggle Worm. I don't care what anybody says. I'm taking it. I like Wiggle Worm a lot.
Whoa, Mike is gonna sex anyone who is nice to him about being sick.
Wow, okay.
Sounds like you're getting laid tonight.
Sounds like I'm getting single tonight. Jeez Louise.
What?
Nothing.
You were nice to him. You're like the one person who's being nice to him instead of making fun of him.
No, if he's gonna sex all the people.
Well, yeah, but that doesn't mean, you know, it could just be an orgy.
I don't want to sex the people. No offense, Doxy Chat.
Sex the people. That's a good phrase. Hashtag sex the people. Thanks, Obama. Why did you take Wiggle Worm?
Because I love it.
What?
It's fun.
It's fun to just miss things for no reason?
It's super fun, especially if you get, like, gigantic tears or, like, a laser of some kind.
It's pretty good with lasers. I'll give you that. Man, I can't wait until Rebirth comes out.
I'm so fucking excited.
The gifts that he keeps putting out are just like, oh my god.
Yeah, crazy.
The greatest. Like, he's revamping the way items work with each other, which is awesome. Because there's
yeah,
so many.
Yeah, he's focused on synergies, and that's really, really exciting.
Yeah, because right now there's so many item combinations that, like, just don't do anything.
Yeah.
Like, one item will override the other.
Yeah.
And it seems like he's trying to largely get rid of that, which
eliminate
is fucking
it, yeah.
Cool. Oh, man, I can't believe it.
I'm incredibly excited.
Yeah, it'll be so good just to be able to play Rebirth for head-to-head instead of normal Isaac.
Okay, so I'm gonna reroll this. Actually, first I'm gonna go see what is in the secret room. Do you know the formula for secret rooms? Aw, fucking A, man.
What do you mean the formula?
For where a secret room can be.
It's most likely to have three adjacent rooms, but it doesn't have to. I don't think there's a formula to it, it's just very likely to have three adjacent rooms. Beyond that, it's just random.
I feel like
and sometimes there are no secret rooms.
Yeah, I definitely know about that one. But I feel like there are like more rules. There are more rules to it than that. There's like, it can't be next to so and so and whatnot.
I don't think there are any rooms that can't be next to.
Fuck. I think it can't be next to a boss room.
I want to say I'm like 90% sure that's not true, but I really don't know. The chat would probably know better than me.
Jeez Louise. Somebody tried to tell me like all these crazy rules for it, but like I just did not understand what they were saying at all.
It can only be adjacent to two rooms if the room to the right of it is an end room. Alright.
Wait, what?
Like, it can be adjacent to two rooms.
Oh, okay, yeah.
One of those. Yeah.
I get what you mean now, for sure. I hate the Duke of Flies. He's so easy, but he's also so. Like, it's really easy for shit to get out of control.
The Duke of Flies?
Yeah.
This dude has, like, zero attack power. And zero health.
But he spits out so many flies!
Yeah, but you just gotta. I mean, they're flies. They're very slow.
Things can get out of hand, Green.
That's fair enough. Apparently, the boss or the secret room can be next to a boss. I was pretty sure that was the case as well.
Okay, check out the devil room. I don't want either of the things in here, but there is a one heart deal, so I'm tempted to reroll, but I think I'm just gonna say no to crack and go reroll the eight ball.
Dur143, I don't think the devil room actually takes up physical space on the floor. Like, I'm pretty sure even if the boss room was next to the secret room, the devil room could open the same way, if that makes sense. You're not gonna reroll the devil room.
Mm-mm.
You're crazy.
You're crazy.
You're crazy.
You're crazy.
Could have rolled, gotten like 9 lives and mom's knife. Just get out of control.
I am out of control. I didn't.
You're out of
the
order.
Devil room. Oh god.
Oh, we got some fart slides going on. What happened?
Did.
Oh,
Redemption,
Redemption just subscribed.
Thank you so much for the support. It means a whole lot to me. Every single sub is a step closer to doing this full time and having more streams and more videos and just doing what I love to do. So I am eternally grateful for every single one of you. Get those fire slides in chat. Thank you very much.
That was a nice speech.
Thank you. I try.
Hmm. Is the bottom of the stream cut off for anybody else? Is that just me?
It's for everybody. Sorry. Hmm.
Okay,
people keep telling me to play in spider mod and it'll fix it. What?
Somebody said Doxy Rage looks like Mike with a mustache.
It kinda does.
It really does.
That's pretty great. Alright, I am going to take the Cat of Nine Tails, just so that I don't get it again. I did it.
Is Biznap the skinny tan guy? I think that's what you're thinking of.
Yes.
Yeah.
He is that.
Man, like, every single dude in our group is skinny, except for me.
That's not true. Rob's not, like, super
Yeah,
thin.
That's true. There's Rob. Rob and I are the fat guys.
Justice, aw yeah. Don't you hate it when Justice spawns a fucking live bomb? Isn't that the
Justice!
Worst?
It's pretty bad.
It makes me very sad. I think I want to use this the world card really bad, just so that I can prioritize rerolls.
Yeah. You go for it.
I'm doing it. I did it. No regrets. People are gonna get really mad though. I love Wiggle Worm. It gets shit on so much.
It's bad. Like, clearly bad.
I am going to gamble down to 18 cents, lose right away, and leave.
I don't know, like the only thing you said about Wiggleworm is that it's fun.
It is fun.
Is that the only thing you like about it?
It's also good with lasers.
But you don't have a laser.
Yeah, but I might get one.
That's true.
And until then, still, it's fun.
Most people find it frustrating is the issue.
I don't find it frustrating. Like, I find it fun.
It's.
I hope you mean fun-strating, Green.
It gets shit on because it has no advantage and many disadvantages. I don't know what more you want from an item to make it bad.
I like it.
Okay.
It has advantages. Like, when you have good damage going, it's a thing.
What do you mean when you have good damage?
When you have like big tiers, or if you have
If you have big lasers. Tiers, I don't think the actual hitbox of the tier changes. It's like when your body changes size. Like you still have the same exact hitbox.
Really?
I'm like 98% sure about that.
Huh. I was unaware. I've always felt like it's done things, but like that could totally just be like the power of suggestion. Man.
Wiggleworm is a fire rate up, you're not wrong. It's like one tier's up and then you miss half your shots.
I didn't know that. I am getting hit so much by these guys.
Even without the tiers up?
Yep. It's fun, man!
Crazy.
You're crazy. We could do this again. I can go all night.
Just going back and forth saying, calling each other crazy.
Yeah, that's what this stream is now. You're crazy.
You're crazy.
You're crazy.
You're crazy.
You're crazy. Oh, fuck crazy. This room so hard.
I win.
Yeah, you do. Well.
Oh, jeez. Chaos is doing a giveaway. And nice. Anybody who says goodnight, Chaos, is out of the running. I like that.
What game are you giving away, Chaos?
Let me scroll up and see if I can find it. I can't find it.
Chaos is such a huge supporter of the stream. It makes me so happy. Chaos, you're a good dude.
He's a super nice person.
Thanks for being nice to everybody all the time.
Oh, Dark Souls 2? Oh, that's right. Yeah, you tried to give me Dark Souls 2, and I was like, oh, dude, I already have it. So he was like, okay, I'll give it away in the DDC. And I was like, wow, you're nice.
That is super nice. I can't believe you're giving away Dark Souls 2. That is just absolutely unheard of nice.
Yeah, I think he, like, bought it for somebody, and then they ended up already having it, and then he tried to find a home for it, and he couldn't. But anyway, there's a story behind it for sure. But still super nice.
Still, obviously. Yeah, totally crazy nice. He already bought it for me, too.
What a nice dude.
Yeah. Like, no warning, no anything, just it shows up. He's just like, have fun on DDC, and I'm like, fuck you a little bit, but okay. Oh, God.
That'll be fun. Have you played it at all on the console?
No, I have only watched Mike play.
Ah, but you spoiled yourself a little bit.
I'm okay with that.
I don't know anything about it.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Don't tell me things.
I'm not gonna tell you things.
you said that in a way that was like, oh, do I have some stuff to tell you?
No, not at all. I'd never do that.
I'm really looking forward to it.
Oh, there's one minor thing that I really want to spoil, but I'm not gonna do it.
What is Mike Malbec's favorite color? I have no idea.
I think it's blue. I could be wrong.
Better be green. I'm breaking up with him.
You can't do- only I can do that!
Plaid. Money color!
Ooh shit, I just got a fucking Eternal Heart. That's rad. And Squeezy. Which is fantastic. I feel really slow. Are you there?
Yes, sorry, I was reading chat.
That's A-okay.
You do seem a little bit slow. You're right.
I feel slow.
It's weird because most flying items are also a speed up, but Transcendence is not. So you always feel, or I always feel sluggish when I have it.
Yeah, I definitely feel pretty slow. I feel like I have enough bombs and money to go gamble a little bit, but I also just don't want to. So I'm just going to grab my Eternal Heart and go.
Yeah, fuck that. The answer was green 90-90. Oh, okay. I'm surprised anyone...
Were they playing 20 questions for the copy of Dark Souls 2?
I don't think so, no. They just, the question was, what was Mike's favorite color? And Mike apparently told Chaos right before the answer is green 90-90. You're cute, Mike. I like you.
You want me?
Hmm?
Nothing. I said you want me.
I still don't understand it.
UWOTM8. Oh,
gotcha. I'll fight you, I swear on me, Mom.
Yeah, there it is.
Green actually is his favorite color. Nice. High five for green favorite color people.
Totally thought it was blue.
Wow. What a girlfriend.
I am the best.
Ah, well, at least I wasn't even close. That's all you do. It was never blue! Mike, if you're gonna just, like, sit here and watch the stream, you should...
Yeah, you might as well just hang out. Beeb.
My favorite color is whatever color Doxy's eyes are. That sounds sweet until you realize that he doesn't know what color your eyes are.
He actually totally knows what color my eyes are. That was really good, though.
I know.
I hate this room! Stop putting me in it. Also, I really want coffee. During our first break, I am going to make some fucking coffee, and it's going to be great.
Coffee does sound good.
I keep craving it, like, super late at night.
I spilled a bunch of coffee while I was visiting Katie.
Like, on yourself?
No. Like, there was a little counter space to put stuff into coffee at the bagel place. And I was... We'd actually waited a long time to go and get food, and I was really hungry, and my hands were shaking just a little tiny bit. I tried to put the lid back on the coffee, dropped it, tried to grab it, and, like, rammed it against the coffee cup and sloshed it everywhere.
Oh, no.
Awful.
I'm glad you didn't, like, burn the fuck out of yourself.
Oh, yeah, it was fine. It wasn't that hot either.
Shitty.
Like, it wasn't McDonald's hot.
McDonald's isn't even McDonald's hot anymore.
Yeah, not since they got sued for it.
No shit. Ah, super greed. Just missed like six shots in a row and you're gonna be like, fucking wiggle worm, why do you like it? And I'm gonna be like, shut up, green 90-90. It's fun. Also, I'm taking a shitload of damage to super greed. I want to know.
That really is like the poster child for Wiggle Worm being a piece of shit. Just, they kept on curving around him over and over and over again.
I'm going to die in this room.
No, there's no way. Look how low health he is. I don't believe it.
I didn't die. Yeah. Now the question is, do I reroll the quarter? I kind of feel like I should.
Yeah, you have 16 cents, it looks like to me. Yeah, no. You don't.
Well, I just got the fucking sale. I'm gonna leave that there.
Yeah, reroll that too.
If I can. We're getting kind of low on rooms. I can absolutely go fight that arena at some point. And that will give me an extra charge that I would not have otherwise gotten.
Yeah, you're guaranteed only to have one more shop because it will be on the depths one. And then it won't be on the depths too. That will be greed again. So, money and
things. Are you sure it'll be greed again?
Yes.
Like every time you get greed on Catacombs 2, you get it on Depths 2 also?
Yes.
Okay.
And then I think if you get Depths XL, it counts as the second floor, so yep. That should be greed as well.
Totally.
So yeah, there's no chance of you getting more than one more shop. And there's a chance you won't even get one more shop. So money is pointless.
Also, wanting to get the habit is like a thing that is going on in my life right now.
Habit's pretty good. I was gonna say you already have it, but then I remembered you died.
Yeah, I totally died.
Man, remember back in the day when you had the habit? That was good.
And me and the small rock, just like crazy damage for fucking yeah. Cell or two, and then I died on the caves.
Those were the days.
They were. Okay, let's go reroll that sucker. Oh, jeez Louise.
Wait, what are you talking about printing? Oh, Doxy's business cards.
Oh, yeah. Fucking FedEx, man. They screwed. Okay, first we took them to Staples, and Staples, like, just their machine didn't like the size of me or Mike's cards. And Mike got his, Mike's were still okay. Mine were, like, cut off. I'm just going to take this, by the way. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. And so, but mine were, like, not usable. And then we went to FedEx in the city, in Boston, and they printed them with, like, a half-inch border of white around the business card. Like they just shrunk my business card. And
what?
Yeah, it was fucking so dumb.
So, hang on. They printed a bunch of them like that instead of just one and 200, being like, whoops?
200.
Oh, my God.
And they charged us, like, $50 for them.
You paid them?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they gave us business cards.
Yeah, but they weren't acceptable.
They were really unacceptable.
Again, but not
shitty. I emailed them about it and about like how unhappy I was. They've just like flat out ignored me.
I would just straight up not pay. I would be like, hang on, print these properly and then I will give you your money.
I'm getting Spoonbender. That's gonna be interesting.
Ooh, more like Spooder Bender.
Hey-o.
Hey-o. Sorry.
That's okay.
Oh, hey, that kind of fixes your bullshit wiggle worm problem, though.
I like wiggle worm.
Well, now you are allowed to.
Oh, shit, I can't go into... Fuck!
You can't go into fuck.
I can't the go worst. Into fuck. He has a fever.
Been there. Doxy, my spooner needs bending. Poor baby.
Oh no, I always die on this guy.
Is it bloat?
It's fucking carry-on queen.
Yeah, it's gotta be the toughest caves boss. If you're on drugs, just come into the stream, man. What could go wrong?
Shooting out tiny hearts, by the way.
Yeah, that's what this guy does. Instead of the AIDS poop, though, so...
Not okay with either thing. I'm definitely gonna die again, unless this is a full pill. Nope, it's a tears down. And by full pill, I meant
perfect.
Full health pill.
I actually like this version of Carrion Queen a lot more than the AIDS poop version.
Okay, here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna float over this rock and let fucking Dead Bird take the victory.
Yeah, Dead Bird! Do it!
I'm gonna die otherwise. There's like literally
for
nothing
sure.
else that I can do.
I love strats like this. It's so good.
I feel like an idiot, but I can totally read chat and take a drink of my tea.
Mm-hmm.
Sup, dudes?
Go, Dead Bird, go! Just bite that butt. Girl.
Biting the shit out that butt. Now the other one.
Is that green 9090? It is indeed. Green 9090. How are you doing, Trollmeister? Trollmeister. Why did that take me time to read?
Because you're a silly man. Alright, now we're going to go take the rest of our pills. and hope for some really good stuff in here. Alright, what's the white one?
Dead bird
fly.
MVP.
That's pretty good. And then a bad trip pill, which turns into a full health pill versus the tower. I'm definitely going to take that. And by that, I mean bad trip.
It's too bad you didn't have that before you took all those hearts.
Yeah. Would have been real good.
I guess you're leaving the floor anyway. Never mind.
Yeah. It's still, it would have, it like, I would have had it, taken it, and found out that it was bad trip. Well, I would have thought that it was full health and then picked up the other one and had another full health pill, basically.
Yep.
So we have a white glitch going on, it seems, maybe? It's definitely just sitting there on Isaac crying for a second.
Yeah, that happens sometimes.
There
the spider
go.
Mod fixes that, I'm pretty sure.
It does.
Spider mod's really good.
I should start
recently,
using spider mod.
We were doing a head-to-head recently, and my computer crashed. Like, I had to restart the whole computer because I couldn't open any more programs. It was a really weird thing that happened. When I got back, I just got into spider mod. Ouch. I had the video from the previous game. So I just looked at the item list at the end of the last video and gave myself all the same items, put myself on the same floor, and was like, well, and we're back.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was the best thing in the world. We didn't have to start the whole recording over.
Yeah, that makes all the sense to do.
Yeah, I liked it.
You said it like somebody touched your penis. You're like, I liked it.
I do like that too.
I hear it's a good thing.
Mm-hmm. Good night, Melio and Chaos.
Good night. Are they actually leaving? Don't laugh at me.
Somebody's just saying goodnight, Chaos, because they're an asshole.
Ah.
It's Unix 388. Chaos says that he is forever banned from future giveaways.
I see.
Green 9 inch, I wish.
No, you don't, dude.
No?
No. If I saw, if somebody fucking took down their pants to reveal a 9 inch fucking penis and expected to have sex with me, I would be like, are you like trying to kill me with that thing? Like, what are you doing with that thing? Put it away. Like, I would not be interested at all. I'd be scared. I just died with a full health pill. Are you kidding me?
No way.
Yeah, I sure did.
Oh no!
I'm so bad.
You must have gotten hit
game.
By one of the giant tears.
Yeah. Yeah.
In fairness, you were talking about 9-inch penises, so.
I was distracted and terrified.
Green 90 inches. That's a lot of inches.
Aw, the parasite! Getting all the fun items, man. I wish I had gotten that on my last run with fucking Wiggleworm and Spoonbender. That would be sweet.
Yeah, Spoonbender especially is so fucking good with the parasite. That's a really fun combo.
Oh, yeah, we might as well go in here.
I remember when I first started using Cheat Engine, there was a glitch with the current version of the Cheat Engine table where it didn't work well with the parasite. Like, giving yourself the parasite just broke it. And the very first run I wanted to try was Spoonbender Parasite.
Aww.
So I added Parasite, and then it just fucking stopped working. I was like, ah, damn, I guess Cheat Engine doesn't work for me.
It
took me like a week to figure out.
Yeah.
That was what had happened.
I am so terrible at figuring out how to use things like Cheat Engine and Spider Mod. I'm really bad at it.
Spider Mod is so ridiculously user-friendly. It's fucking crazy how good that program is.
I haven't really checked it out, though.
It's
not
good.
Much. Only I to haven't... play the same seed as Larkin one time for a video.
Yeah, that's super easy, and I just, like, every time Zen and I have to use it for something new for Head-to-Head, it's like, oh, well, that was easy. Like, there's just a one of the coolest features is there's a teleport function. You just go to the teleport thing and it brings up a fucking visual map of the floor that you're on, fully marked, and you can just go to any room you want.
That is pretty sweet.
Yeah, it just always works. It's so incredible.
Can you make it so that I am error rings show up like all the time?
I think there's an ability to just go to the I am error room. I'm not sure if there's any more than that. Well, now I understand that people with 9-inch penises aren't welcome here.
Oh, that's not what I mean. I'm just not going to have sex with you.
That's even worse.
Okay, blowing my last bomb on this secret room. Better be good. It's pretty good. 10 cents. Nothing to shake a stick at.
Yeah, Larkin's on first name basis with Edmund McMillan.
And Derek Yu.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm taking my giant penis and going home, says Michael.
You are home, Beef. Oh.
Swings on the shoulder, walks away.
We have an arcade, which is exciting to me.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, you know those, like, stupid t-shirt ads that are all over the internet?
Which ones?
Just all of them. Like, there are so many ads that are like, check out these funny t-shirts, okay, usually worn by a hot girl.
Yeah.
And they're always super lame. I saw one that I actually really liked. It was like, Aurelia! And it was like Cthulhu Kool-Aid Man, like, bursting through a wall. Pretty
yeah,
great.
Yeah, that's really good.
It was great. I wanted it. Not enough to actually click on it, but it looks pretty good.
I have no keys and no bombs.
Nothing to shake a stick at. That stick better not be 9 inches or larger.
Oh, jeez Louise.
Is that your cutoff? What is the cutoff?
We don't have to talk about this. We could talk about something else.
All right.
I really need a fucking key, for instance. I fucking hate these spiders. There's no telling how fucking far they're going to jump, ever.
Oh or shit, Mike has Paranautical Activity shirts.
Yeah, they're awesome too.
That's great.
Well, real glad. Real glad. Oh wait, maybe there's a chest in there, which will allow me to get a key. And if not, then I will go gamble for a key and it'll be awesome. Maybe it'll have, like, many keys, and lots of money, and blunts and bitches.
Maybe it'll have a skeleton key.
It had just a couple cents, and a red heart.
Oh, I'm actually pretty far behind. Perhaps I will stop and restart.
That's a thing you could do.
Yep. Now you're fighting jumpers, like the...
Yeah, that's just... not far behind at all. Cool. I just got to the third wave of enemies.
I just got to the second, so yeah, not too bad.
Not bad at all.
I want to be a multiplayer shirt.
Can I be the voice of the shirt?
Oh, that would be awesome to have shirts with little like gift card-esque speakers in them.
Paranautical Activity!
I would just go, oops.
Or just a thing in the shirt that you can press that says pornhub.com/users/spooterw.
Okay, fuck it. We're gonna go fight this boss. And it's gonna
wow,
be
you just attempted to use a spike room.
Yeah, I did.
That is a rare
I had extra hearts on the floor, and I'm not scared to be at one heart on... Cellar 2 at all.
Famous last words.
I live dangerously. I die a lot.
You know, Pin could one-shot you at one heart.
Yeah, with his green bombs.
Yeah.
I've been hit by those before. I'm not proud of it.
Too busy fucking one-shotting himself with them.
Yeah, really.
I get hit by those things all the time, BT Dubs.
Doxy won't smoke a blunt over 7 inches. That'd be a huge blunt, man. I don't know about that.
God damn it.
You would need a bong for a blunt that big, right?
What?
If you have a 7-inch blunt, you would need to put it in a bong.
Oh, no. You can't put that big. It will overflow it. You put it in the water, it'll overflow it.
What if you have a gravity bong?
Well, then you're in space, and you have bigger problems than blunts.
Yeah, now you're in the movie Gravity. He's floating around.
Well, there's a key in a bomb. At least I can get into the goddamn item room now. I'm gonna...
Hey, Zen!
Hi, Zen! I'm going to...
Oh, no!
...gamble down to nothing.
This is the greatest Zen intro I've ever seen. Somebody says, Zen, are you a nympho? Zen says, am I a nympho? No, but I need to have my hair cut, so be back in a bit.
That's pretty good.
I don't know, what's the cutoff age for a nympho? I feel like it's like 17.
A cutoff for a nympho? There is no cutoff age for a nympho.
Doesn't that specifically mean like somebody who's young and into sex?
No.
Are you sure?
It just means somebody who has lots and lots of sex all the time.
Really?
Yeah.
Nympho definition. Google, send me straight here. Nympho, a nymphomaniac. Thanks, Google.
That's really good.
Oh, yeah. Afflicted with abnormally excessive sexual desire.
Yep.
Never mind. I really thought that it applied specifically to young girls.
The old nymphomania.
Yeah. Were we zeroing in on my penis size while we were getting through? Yes.
Are people, like, trying to guess?
Yeah, I think based on your reactions to various penis sizes.
Oh, golly. What have I done?
Because you're a pussy.
What have I done?
Oh, man. It would be awesome to have a 6.9-inch penis. I wouldn't mind.
Yeah,
that.
It would.
Yeah.
Oh, we have Ipecac and Parasite. Should I do it? I'm gonna do it.
Does that even... I don't think that does anything.
It's gotta.
I really doubt...
Oh, that was chemical peel anyway. I'm a big idiot.
Yeah, it is. That's a good item, though.
Yeah, I'll take it. I wouldn't have rerolled
3 inches, I call it the triple decker. Triple dick.
Fuck. Why did I think I had so many more bombs than I had?
Last time you died, you had like 17 of them.
I thought I had like a lot of bombs.
Yeah.
And I didn't. And I just spent them looking for the secret room and not finding it.
No!
Yeah, that was pretty bad. Oh, no. Okay. Fucking no! Oh, God. Come on, bro.
Now we should do Ipecac My Reflection head to head soon.
You can't do that, can you? Like it just kills you, right?
I mean, it tries really hard.
But it doesn't have to.
Yeah, it's. I mean, you just have to be like careful with it.
Got it.
You have to dance with your shots. Every time you shoot, you have to have a plan. It's hard.
That would suck really bad in a room where you, I don't know why I didn't go down here. In a room where you, like, were surrounded by a rock maze or whatever. Like, that would suck in, like, a wrath fight.
It's not as bad as you think, because you can just blow up the rocks. Oh, not in a wrath fight, you're right.
In a wrath fight, you would probably honestly just have to exclusively kill him by, excuse me, kicking his own bombs at him.
Yeah.
But in a normal room with a bunch of rocks in it like that, then you can just blow them up.
It'll hurt you.
If you stand in a way where you can shoot it, so it doesn't kill hit you immediately, and then you just guide it into a rock before it gets back.
Okay.
Yeah, we'd probably make the ending condition for that, like, beat the caves.
I'm really
spend
bad.
The whole 45 minutes. Sorry?
I'm really bad. I'm just taking a shitload of damage to the fucking diagonal Larry Jr. guy.
Yeah, you are. Oh, God. You gotta stand in the middle. That way you have some place to dodge. If you get into a corner, you've already lost. Sun Tzu, Yoda 4. I don't think that's true.
What?
I acted as if I had made a Sun Tzu quote, but I don't think I did.
Oh, okay.
Never mind.
I'm not minding, ever.
Excellent. Thank you.
Of course.
It's really nice of you.
I'm not ever, ever going to mind. Ever. You can't make me.
Never say never.
Oh,
only Sith
on.
Deal in absolutes. Wait, hang on. You have watched Star Wars, but you don't like it.
Me?
Yeah.
I love Star Wars.
You like Star Wars?
Yeah.
There are all these people. You're the one who hasn't played Pokemon.
Yes. Polyphemus.
Somebody else doesn't like Star Wars very much. And then somebody else hasn't watched Star Wars. Katie's the one that hasn't watched Star Wars. That would make a lot of sense.
She's like, yeah. Like, just young enough where that's kind of expected.
Really?
I feel like, yeah.
People don't show little kids Star Wars anymore. 19 years ago.
Yeah, I don't know. Nobody ever I didn't see it until I was like 22.
I saw it in the fucking theaters.
Yeah, I don't know.
I was like 4 years old.
I made it when people started like giving me a lot of shit about not having seen Star Wars, I made it a point to not see Star Wars. And then I would use that as a way to get nerdy dudes to hang out with me. I'd be like, I've never seen Star Wars. And they'd be like, we have to watch Star Wars together. I'd be like, okay.
And then you didn't.
We wouldn't, yeah.
You were a Star Wars tease.
Well, they wouldn't be like, okay, let's watch Star Wars now. Like, we'd go back to their house and they'd be like, okay, what do you want to do? And then we'd like drink beers and stuff instead.
Yeah.
Play video games.
That's pretty much how it is with Katie and I, actually. Like, I'm always like, we should really just watch Star Wars sometimes. Or sometime. And then we don't. And same thing with a lot of movies,
shit.
Like Big Lebowski. Okay.
Big Lebowski is so good. I don't think Mike has seen Big Lebowski either.
Oh, man. Watch it with him.
I should. I want to make him watch Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Which is, like, my favorite Coen Brothers movie.
I haven't seen that.
Oh, it's so good. It's so good. You gotta see it.
I would like to. I like Coen Brothers a lot.
Yeah, they're amazing. I've never disliked anything they've ever put out.
Me neither. Be great.
They are.
90 years old. I've heard this Star Wars story before, says Mike Mulbeck. I assume he's seen Star Wars.
I don't know. We don't ever talk. We just hold hands.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
All day, every day. I don't remember.
He's even younger than Katie.
Yeah, he's young.
But a wee lad. I was surprised when I heard his birthday was in August. I kind of thought that he had already turned 20. I ain't seen no Star Wars. Come on, man. He just seemed like the kind of person who would have seen Star Wars at some point.
Agreed. Like, he gets all kinds of references from shit from, like, the 80s and 90s, so, like, I just always assume that he knows shit I know about pop culture.
Yeah. He definitely knows more than me about pop culture. I don't watch enough shit.
Oh man, best.
Cool dude.
I'm a really big fan. Oh golly, okay, I thought I was gonna take some damage from a human centipede there, and I didn't.
Spooter is only 12, right? Yep.
It's 13 or 14 by now.
Oh shit, Emerson Kitson bringing out the huge pop culture cred. He has seen Star Wars. He was 16. Are you still 16? I thought you were 17 by now.
He's a young man.
Yeah, Emerson, God damn yeah. It. He's got a tiny head. I wonder if his head will grow when he gets older.
I hate it when I take a chance and it doesn't pay off. But yeah, it's not enough to stop taking chances.
100% of the time, I would use a bomb on a chest.
Yeah.
Like, that is such a huge chance of paying out.
I can't believe I got out of that without taking damage. I just straight up can't believe that that happened. Have you ever seen... Do you watch Bob's Burgers?
No.
Me and Mike have been watching Bob's Burgers lately, and it is like... one of the funniest shows I've ever seen, and I think you would absolutely fucking love it. You gotta watch it. You just have to. It is
I'm
right
in for
up
that.
Your alley.
You guys wanna watch it with me sometime?
I'm down for that. We're up to season 3, though. We actually, we watch it like every night, so.
Oh, wow.
You probably won't catch up with us.
All right.
But. You should totally watch it. You and Katie can watch it together. And just laugh a whole lot.
Yeah, I'll see if I can get her to do that. She's been pretty busy lately. It's like getting into final season for her.
Yeah, totally.
She's one of those responsible people with things to do.
Gross. Yeah. Why would you even marry her if that was the case?
you know. I'm young and stupid.
Alright, so we have Brimstone and Mom, or not Mom's Foot, Luckfoot. I'm not gonna take either of them, just so you know.
Luckfoot is so good.
I can't take it. It's for 3 soul hearts and I only have one.
Yeah, fuck that. Okay. Yeah. Brimstone's really good.
I hate it.
Alright, reroll it.
I didn't. I just left.
Why not? Why?
Because I want the angel rooms. I prefer angel rooms to devil rooms because then I don't have to give up max health.
What if you got, like, a pact or something?
The pact would be really good. Don't get me wrong. But having health is really good when you're zero doxing.
Yeah, but you're gonna get an angel room, and you know what's gonna be in it? Fucking, like, Scapular, the Bible.
Scapular is good.
Not as good as the pact.
That's fair.
It's like
you got blood rites in here.
Item.
That's really good, right?
What is, sorry?
I was just kidding. Blood rites.
Oh yeah, that's an excellent pickup.
Celtic Cross, do I want that? Or should I keep trying for rerolls?
That's a tough choice.
I'm gonna keep trying for rerolls, I think.
Yeah. Celtic Cross for me is right on the border between worth picking up and worth rerolling.
What's it do?
You don't know what it does?
Mm-mm.
It's upon getting hit, I think you have about a 10% chance of making a Polaroid shield.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Might be more like 5% chance, but it's a chance of making a Polaroid shield around you.
Definitely not good enough for me to not try to reroll it, though.
Yeah. The only danger is you're going to run into more spacebar items, and then it will just be a wasted chance to pick up an item.
Oh, well. Live dangerously.
Well. Nobody ever watched porn before 18. You're totally right.
Yeah.
I remember being 13 and being like, I really want to look at pictures of boobs on the internet, but they all have this Are You 18 agreement.
Yeah, I'm
first.
Not old enough for that.
Yeah, exactly. I have to click no.
What would Jesus
and then
think?
when you click no, it like some sites were so funny. They would like send you to SesameStreet.com and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, or like Legoland or whatever.
Yeah. It's really good. I don't know if that's still a thing, but it used to be in the 90s.
It's definitely still a thing.
Is it really?
Yeah.
It's awesome.
It was on a website for a brewing, like a beer brewing company that I checked out recently.
That's really good.
I don't remember what it took me to, but it was definitely like a little kid site. I think it was right. Like the Wiggles or some shit. I got Able. Ew. Let's keep trying for rerolls.
That is an awful item.
Yeah, I hate Able. Like
one time I thought I had such a good challenge run idea. It was like, okay, I'm going to have Mom's knife and I can only shoot with Able. It's a bad idea because Able does no damage. Yeah, otherwise, Able it would have been really fun.
Terrible.
Yeah, if he just did like Sister Maggie damage, it would be fine.
Well, Sister Maggie scales with you, doesn't she?
Does she?
I think she does.
I'm not sure.
We just got.
I just know she does pretty decent damage. You need to be in the presence of a parent or guardian to watch porn under 18. That sounds fun.
That's the way that I watch porn after 18, personally.
Sorry?
That's the way that I watch porn after 18, personally.
Yeah.
Okay, let's check out our health situation here. We've got an eternal heart. We've got a half heart there. I'm seriously considering harming myself in order to get into that boss room there, the boss arena.
Science is still trying to figure out the extent of the danger on the internet.
Got one for 3 cents there.
Speaking of which, my parents are coming over to watch some porn with us.
Sounds good. I'll make spaghetti.
Have you met Mike's parents yet?
No, I have not.
They sound like fascinating people.
They do.
Hopefully his mom doesn't think that you're like the kind of person who shouldn't sit next to him in a diner.
He like doesn't want me to meet them at all.
That's reasonable. Did you check out the boss trap room?
I'm going to right now.
Good. I was afraid you were moving toward the boss room on my screen. I was a little bit worried.
I have to hurt myself a lot.
No, that's a boss trap room.
Yeah, I have to be down to one heart for that.
I'm an idiot.
You're not an idiot. You're the best.
I got them mixed up. Oh, you're hitting yourself a lot. You're going to lose that spirit heart? Oh, yep. Man.
That's the plan. Doxy lives dangerously.
Don't hurt yourself, Doxy.
It's not worth it.
Tell the story about almost meeting my sister.
Okay, so yeah, that's a health up. I'm definitely.
Wait, Mike has a sister?
Uh-huh. And she's like completely socially inept, apparently, because it was like right when we got here with like the U-Haul and stuff. And his mom and his sister came in to pee, and like I was just not ready for that. I was just not ready to meet them because we had literally like 10 minutes prior walked in the door, and like I was hiding behind a door just because I didn't want them to even know that I was there. Like, didn't even want them to know that I was there.
How did they? There's a moving van. Why did they think it was there?
Because Mike preloaded them with a lie that he was helping somebody else move.
Oh man.
Yeah. Anyway, so
what were they doing there?
They were there to pick him up to take him to get Elvis because Elvis had been boarded.
Oh. Okay.
All right, we got a dagger. I'm pretty okay with that. Anyway, so she sees me behind the door and is just like, is like, who is that behind the door? I see that person behind the door. And like just won't fucking let it go. And Mike is just like, I'm very lonely up here in the mountains. I put a cardboard cutout on a Roomba and let it glide around. And he's just like, and she was like, no, I saw a human being. And he was just like, it's a really nice Roomba. Yeah. And she just wouldn't let it go. She just wouldn't. And like it was obvious that I did not want to be found or talked to or anything. Yeah, it was absolutely ridiculous.
It's a cardboard cutout. Oh my god.
Yeah. Like, it was just super clear that he didn't want to talk about it. I didn't want to meet anybody. Like, and she just would not fucking let it go at all. It was seriously ridiculous. I'm really glad you're enjoying yourself so much.
That is the most Mike Malbec thing in the fucking world. To be like, oh yeah, that's a cardboard cutout riding around on a Roomba. Yeah. Hiding behind my door, don't worry about it.
We're thinking about getting a Roomba just for Sparta to ride around on.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Yeah, do you have seen any
that
idea
gif of the cat
videos?
Riding a Roomba?
Oh god, there's so many of them. There's so many of them. And I watch them whenever I'm in a bad mood, and it fixes everything.
It's really good. So wave like stupidity isn't an act. I'm sorry, I just can't get off the idea of somebody seeing a human being hiding behind a door and Mike just trying to play it off like it's a cardboard cutout on a Roomba.
Yeah, it was pretty good. It was really hard to not laugh and like totally give my shit away. Like, as if I wasn't already like completely busted for being there.
Uh-oh.
Hello?
Yeah, the call totally cut out for me for a second.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good because you couldn't chastise me for the horrible job that I'm doing. Goat fucking curved horn, I mean. Goat horn. I'm an idiot.
I'm gonna be honest here, I can't understand a thing you're saying.
Really? I haven't lost the stream yet.
Okay, you sound a little better now. Like, for a while, it was like I could hear one syllable every five syllables.
I feel like that means Mike might be, like, looking at videos or something. Oh, what am I doing?
Yep, you said.
Oh, we have a 7-cent battery, and I want it. I also want the fucking soul heart, though.
Oh, dude, the battery.
Yeah, man.
That battery.
That battery, duh.
Doxy, can I please highlight that story?
Yeah.
That's a really good story.
This is gonna go on YouTube anyway. Like, my streams always go on YouTube.
That little part, though. That's a really good story. This is one of the best stories I've ever heard in my life.
Better than Cam's nipple hair?
Better than what, sir?
Cam's nipple hair? That's a...
Fuck. You're
hard
cutting out again.
Oh no! Cam's nipple hair!
Cam's nipple hair is a really good story. Oh man. I miss Cam.
Yeah, I wish that dude hung out.
Yeah. He's a funny man.
He is a funny man. He makes me laugh often. He's not Mike Malbec funny.
Nah.
But he's pretty funny.
After I left that night with my family to get my dog, my mom was like, good thing you have two bedrooms.
It's true. He told me all about it. I laughed and laughed.
So apparently she noticed you as well.
Well, she wouldn't have said anything, though. Like, she's socially aware enough to leave well enough a fucking alone. And, like, would have not said anything.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. I mean, to me, personally, it seems really odd for you to be in the house hiding behind a door when they're there.
I didn't want to meet that. I had literally just moved in with their son without their knowledge.
But why were you in the house?
What do you mean, why was I in the house? We had just walked in the door, like, 10 minutes ago.
And you didn't know they were there?
No, they got there after us.
Oh, okay.
Fucking just died.
You couldn't like dive out the... Oh, no. I'm sorry.
There's absolutely no diving out the window here, no. Okay, I am going to go make some coffee. We're going to run some ads. Nobody go anywhere. We will be back shortly.